Hey everyone, I just wanted to talk about one really important thing about lucid dreaming. Well, it's in two parts, but I'm not going to talk about exercise in this one. I'm going to talk about exercise in a different video. Today I'm talking about diet. Diet is really important, and people may think, how do I know all this information? Well, diet and exercise is something that I know quite a bit about because my university course, Applied Sports Science Coaching, I know it sounds a bit naff, but I study physiology, biomechanics, nutrition, personal training, coaching, people sport, you know, things like this. So I know quite a bit about diet and exercise because I have to. I just got out of the shower. But anyway, diet is really important for lucid dreaming. If you eat the right things, then all the nutrients from the food that you eat get absorbed into your blood system and help produce endorphins. Well, different hormones and things like this. There's some in particular that play a really big effect, a really big aspect on lucid dreaming, and they are epinephrine, norepinephrine, cortisol, melatonin, and there's another one but I've forgotten it. Those four hormones, those four, you know, endorphins, they play a huge effect on lucid dreaming, especially norepinephrine and epinephrine in wild. They play a huge effect. That's why you've got to study. If you check my wild tutorial, I post a link to another video which goes into great detail. You have to watch that to understand how blood chemistry affects your lucid dreaming in wild. He explains it really well. But basically, there are a few things that are said to help lucid dreaming, and one of them is choline bitartrate. Choline usually gets mixed up with vitamin B, you know, the B complex, the whole B thing. But when people have choline, they say that they become more lucid. They become lucid on a regular basis. The chances of lucidity increase tenfold. And this is possibly just down to the effect that you can remember your dreams a bit better. Because when I took choline bitartrate, it wasn't that I became lucid more often, it was because I came lucid more often because I could remember more of my dreams. My dream recall increased considerably. And as you all know, dream recall is the most important thing, possibly, about lucid dreaming. Because if you don't remember your dreams, then that means you're not conscious in your dreams, so you're not able to remember them. And if you're not conscious in your dreams, you'll never be able to become lucid. Because lucidity is the consciousness of knowing that you're dreaming whilst you're dreaming. Do you understand that? There is another one. I have to double check this pronunciation. Galantamine. It's one of them. And that too has an effect on your lucid dreaming. Some people say it does it lucidity even more, but I haven't heard about it too much. I mean, I've always heard about it, but I had an email off somebody the other day and he said, oh, what about this? And I thought, oh yeah, well that's lucky because I was going to write this video, I was going to do this video. But there's something you have to understand about vitamins and minerals. Your body only utilises what it needs. Say your body needed, I don't know, 100 milligrams of this one vitamin and your diet only gives you 50. If you take a supplement, that gives 100 milligrams, then whatever isn't used gets thrown away through waste products. Won't go into details about that. So your body only utilises what you need. If your diet gives you 95 milligrams and you need only 100 milligrams in your body, and you take a supplement that gives you another 100, you'll only get 5% to 5 milligrams to make up the 100. So all the rest will get chucked away. So if you think that your diet is good, and you've got a really good diet, you know, you get your proteins, your carbohydrates, your healthy fats, and you get all these different things in your diet, vegetables, you know, all that, then there's no point taking it. Because if you take a supplement like choline bitartrate or galantamine, then you won't be able to get any benefits. You probably won't even notice that you took it. But, you know, it's just something to be careful about. Now, if you've got a really unhealthy diet, you don't want to go, vroom, oh, that's it, I'm going and I'm having a healthy diet. Because you do that, you get kicked back. It's called a diet. People say, I'm going on a diet. Well, that just straight away indicates that you're going to go off the diet. If you say, I'm going to change my diet or change my lifestyle, then it doesn't give you the incentive that maybe you will go back. So if you just change it like that, boom, you have pizza every day for your whole life, and then all of a sudden, boom, fresh fruit and veg. Your chances are you're going to binge eat. So you have to dial it down at the same time as dialing up your healthy food. So if you're eating loads of unhealthy food and you want to eat more healthy food, you've just got to substitute one thing at a time. So instead of drinking Coca-Cola all the time, get rid of the Coca-Cola, water. And you do that for a couple of weeks and you keep on changing it, and you'll find that it will be easier and you won't revert back to binging. So again, just to reiterate, diet is important. You need healthy foods in your diet. And my voice is going like that. In order to have a good diet. I don't know if you can hear that buzzing. That's weird. Anyway, my next video might be another Minecraft one, I don't know. But the one after that will be about, I've forgotten, addiction. Because I just wanted to say something about addiction. So see you then.